First, let's understand some different types of meditation techniques. The number one, basically, which is most commonly used even nowadays, that is mantra meditation. So, mantra basically you can say is a set of words, and each word basically has certain vibration. So, when you keep on repeating certain kind of words again and again and again, so vibration associated with those words basically are being created. Does it help? Yes, to some extent, basically, because what happens is that our mind is continuously bombarded with some kind of thoughts throughout the day. As per the research, they said that it's around 65 to 70,000 thoughts every single day our mind is bombarded. So when you keep on basically repeating same word again and again and again, so obviously there's a less bombardment of all those thoughts, and a less basically bombardment of the thoughts, the more basically stress-free you are. But what I see the limitation basically in the mantra meditation is that after reaching to a certain stage, let's say even to each stage, basically there is no other thought is there, only that mantra is there. But then it will be very difficult to get rid of mantra. Because the final stage basically meditation is, which is thoughtless as well as totally free from impurities. So it's not only thoughtless state. Thoughtless as well as freedom from all the impurities. Now, how do you reach to that end stage? Because this mantra basically will be itself become an obstacle. So, for example, if I ask you, if I say to you, don't think about the word monkey, and the only word basically you will think about is monkey. So, when you're continuously repeating that mantra again and again and again, you will not be basically able to get rid of that mantra. So that's basically the limitation part. That's basically when you reach to the end, this mantra basically you will not be able to go. However, with repetition certain mantra, you acquired some siddhis, or you can say some acquired some power. I will discuss that point in the next coming video. But right now, first focusing basically on the meditation technique. Do you get some benefits? Yes, you might feel some relaxation, definitely. But in the end result is when you reach to the end, this mantra itself basically will become the obstacle. I'm not saying whether you should practice it or not, that is your choice. I'm just giving you some idea, and you don't have to be agree with that. Number two, another technique basically could be like, for example, visualization technique. So in that basically you can start visualizing some picture in your mind, or some image, or for example some image or picture of God or goddess, and then you basically keep concentrating your mind on that. So this will again help you that other thoughts basically become less and less and less and less and less. And yes, to some extent you will feel the relaxation. There's another technique basically which Buddha suggested, that was like observe your breath. So when you keep your mind focused on breath, and your mind basically become observe, focus on breath after breath, breath after breath, then also basically that outside thought basically become less and less and less and less. And again, basically, also give you some benefit in terms of relaxations, lesser thoughts, mind become concentrated. All the techniques basically in the meditation helps you that your mind basically become much more concentrated, and it also basically much more become powerful. But the most important point is the technique should be the one which not only help you to become your mind concentrated, but it also helps you to release the impurities from your mind, because all the suffering in our mind actually comes through the impurities. So the meditation technique, whichever you choose, should actually help you not only in concentrating, not only meditation, going to the higher stage of concentration, but also should help you to release the remove the impurities out of your mind. So yeah, these are the techniques basically you can consider and see basically what works best with you. If you have any query, feel free to write your queries in the comment section, and definitely I will try to answer them as much as I can. Next video basically I will make is like about the mantras, mantra siddhis, mantra powers, and whether they are good to acquire. If you think this video was informative, feel free to like it or share it and subscribe the channel. Thanks for watching it.